Picture a skyscraper so tall it slices through clouds. A sci-fi marvel with the fastest elevators on Earth and the highest observation deck ever. Now, imagine it half empty, leaking like a busted dam, and sinking under $1.5 billion in debt. This is Shanghai Tower, China's tallest building and the world's second tallest skyscraper. It was meant to crown a nation's rise, but nearly became an epic flop. Stick around, this story's a wild ride. Welcome back to Blueprint Boss, the channel where we dive deep into the world's most insane engineering projects, successes, flops, and everything in between. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button and ring the bell because you won't want to miss what's coming. Today, we're unpacking the roller coaster saga of the Shanghai Tower, a $2.4 billion skyscraper that promised to be China's crown jewel but nearly collapsed under its own ambition. From economic chaos to design flaws to literally waterfalls cascading through its floors, this journey is a masterclass in how even the grandest blueprints can teeter on the edge of disaster. Let's get into it. Now, let's set the stage. Shanghai Tower stands 632 meters. That's 2,073 feet, making it China's tallest and second only to Dubai's Burj Khalifa worldwide. It's got 128 floors, a spiraling glass facade twisting in the sky, and elevators zipping at 46 miles per hour. Ground to top in under a minute. It's billed as the world's most sustainable megatall skyscraper, packed with green tech. Sounds like a slam dunk, right? Well, hold that thought. Behind the shiny exterior lies a tale of setbacks, scandals, and a building that almost didn't make it. The dream begins. To get how Shanghai Tower got here, rewind to the 1990s. China was exploding onto the global stage, economic reforms turning sleepy towns into buzzing metropolises overnight. Shanghai, once a humble trading port, was morphing into the nation's financial heartbeat. Skyscrapers sprouted like mushrooms after rain, and city planners dreamed big. A trio of supertall towers in Pudong to scream, China has arrived. First, the Jinmao Tower in 1999, a sleek 88-story beauty. Then, in 2008, the Shanghai World Financial Center, dubbed the bottle opener for its quirky top. But those were warm-ups. The main event? Shanghai Tower. The plan kicked off in 1993, but groundbreaking waited until 2008. The goal? A tower taller than anything China had ever built, a symbol of unstoppable growth. Gensler, a top American architecture firm, delivered a stunner, a glass cylinder twisting 120 degrees as it rises, wrapped in an outer skin to cut wind resistance and save energy. Inside, 9 vertical neighborhoods stacked up, each with atriums, shops, offices, like many cities in the sky. The price tag? A cool $2.4 billion. This wasn't just a building, it was a statement. Construction roared to life. By 2012, the core hit 820 feet, workers framing floors like they were racing the clock. Milestones flew by. 90 floors by late 2012, over 1,600 feet by April 2013. On August 3, 2013, the final beam capped it in a grand topping out ceremony. Gensler's co-founder, Art Gensler, said, "Shanghai Tower represents a new way of defining and creating cities. The world watched this spiraling giant redefine Shanghai's skyline. It was meant to be a triumph, a beacon of China's future. But here's where things unravel." Fast forward to 2016. The tower's done. Ribbons cut. Shanghai Tower opens its doors. The hype is sky high, literally. Tourists swarm the observation deck, snapping pics from 1,800 feet up. Elevators hum at breakneck speeds. And its eco-friendly cred scores a LEED Platinum certification, the greenest of the green. But behind the glitz, trouble brews. A skyscraper's not just about height or tech. It's about who's using it. And here's the snag. Nobody wanted to move in. Imagine you're a CEO eyeing China's tallest tower. You're pumped till you hear, sorry, it's not fire safe yet. Or, oh, by the way, 50% of your floor is unusable glass. Would you sign that lease? By 2018, 2 years after opening, the tower was half empty. Half empty. A 128-story, $2.4 billion masterpiece, and floors sat collecting dust. Leased spaces? Mostly domestic Chinese firms, and only 30% of them had moved in. big multinationals Shanghai craved, nowhere in sight. Why? Well, first, red tape. Fire authorities freaked over the 2,000-foot height. Evacuating, that's a nightmare. And fighting a fire up there? Good luck. Full safety certifications dragged on for years, scaring off tenants. Then, timing. China's economy was red hot when the tower was planned, but by the mid-2010s, it cooled. The 2015 stock crash wiped out billions. Companies tightened belts and premium office space wasn't priority one. But the real gut punch? That twisty design. The double-skin facade saved energy but slashed usable space. Some floors hit just 50% efficiency versus 70% in normal towers. You're paying millions for decorative glass. No wonder it racked up $1.5 billion in debt. When it rains, it pours. July 2020. One minute, employees sip coffee at their desks. The next, an indoor tsunami. A pipe or cooling system, details were fuzzy, busts near floor 60. Water gushes down, soaking floors 9 through 60. Desks submerge. Computers fry. Fire alarms wail. Viral clips showed drenched workers dodging sparks as chaos reigns. The internet dubbed it the world's most expensive slip and slide. It was a PR train wreck and a literal disaster. Management scrambled, blaming equipment failure, even calling some clips fake, pointing to old, unrelated footage. But the damage was real. Soaked offices, ruined gear, furious tenants, elevators shut down, businesses stalled, and a full inspection followed. How does a $2.4 billion skyscraper spring a leak this bad? Some blamed construction quality. China's built more towers in decades than the US in a century, often at warp speed. Shanghai Tower took 8 years. Not crazy fast, but ambitious. Corners cut? Maybe not, but cracks slip through when you're racing. Others pointed to the complex green tech. Wind turbines, rainwater systems, double skins. If maintenance isn't perfect, stuff breaks. The bigger picture. Shanghai Tower isn't just a building, it's a warning. When ambition outruns practicality, you don't get an empty skyscraper. You get a $2.4 billion lesson in overreach. But is it a total flop? Not quite. By 2023, occupancy hit 60%, with more tenants trickling in. The J Hotel opened in 2021 on the upper floors, pulling luxe travelers. The observation deck still packs crowds, and its green tech shines. It's no ghost tower, but it's not the roaring wind China banked on either. This mirrors China's megaproject obsession. Ghost cities, half-finished bridges, that 600-meter abandoned tower in Tianjin, it's about projecting power. Not always using it. Critics call it cart before horse. Build big, assume demand follows. Sometimes it works. Burj Khalifa went from vanity project to icon. Sometimes you get Shanghai Tower, a half-lit symbol of ambition outpacing reality. The Empire State Building sat mostly empty in the 30s. Empty state, they called it, before turning a profit decades later. Mega projects are gambles. Will Shanghai Tower fill up, pay off that $1.5 billion debt, or stand as a cautionary tale? That's the wild tale of Shanghai Tower. A $2.4 billion skyscraper that soared to the edge of greatness, stumbled hard, and still might come back. Engineering marvel or overhyped flop? Drop your thoughts in the comments. Let's debate it. Love this? Thumbs up. Subscribe. Hit the bell. More insane blueprints are coming. Until next time, keep looking up, but maybe check for leaks first.